His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Tiabora Museveni has this afternoon finally opened the World Health Summit Regional Meeting Africa 2021. This summit is going to run from the 27th to the 30th of June this year, 2021. It's taking place at the Speak Resort, Munyonyo. Take a look.
Great, great and mighty, the gates beside thee.
The president was in company of the First Lady, Janet Kataha Museveni, as they arrived to open the World Health Summit 2021. This is the first World Health Summit in Africa, and it's hosted by Makerere University.
2 years ago, you came to Makerere University to inspect an exhibition, agriculture exhibition it was. And you say, finally, you seem to be waking up. Indeed, Your Excellency, because of your persistent encouragement and criticism, Makerere University woke up. COVID-19 specifically showed how Makerere University has woken up, and you have referred to some of that. With the first injection of the 30 billion shillings, the innovations coming out of Makerere surprised even me, and I'm saying, where were we all this time?
Of hope and not fear in this challenging time. It is with courage that we shall fight the good fight of faith. I thank all of you who have braved the journey to be here in Uganda in this very difficult time. God bless you all, and I thank you.
Summit seeks to develop solutions to help challenges faced by African continent.
People call it vaccine apartheid, others call it vaccine nationalism. But as I said in my speech, it's very clear that there is vaccine inequity. And that's causing a two-track pandemic because some countries have better access to vaccines and their situation is getting better. Others, low-income countries who don't have access to vaccines, their situation is deteriorating. So I fully agree with His Excellency the President when he says, let's use this as a wake-up call. And in my speech also I said, Africa should not really depend on others for essential things like vaccines, not only COVID vaccines, but even other vaccines too.
This is just immediate to fire brigade now. But I can assure you, for Uganda, in 1 year, 1.5 years, we shall never again be in such a situation. If we can buy from some people, if they want to sell, if they agree, because they are the foreigners have failed the test. The foreigners, professor from Germany, I'm telling you that the foreigners have failed two tests, according to my assessment. Number one, they have failed my tribal test. The foreigners have failed. Zero marks on my tribal code. But they have also failed on the Christian. You remember I had a rumor that there were Christians in the world. That's what we hear. We hear that there are Christians in America, there are Christians in Europe, there are Christians. These people have failed on the Christian test. So we are going to look for the vaccine for the short run, but also they have failed on the test of strategy. Because we now know that they don't care about us.
The president also asked foreign countries to only focus on extending raw materials for making vaccines for the African continent.
The Cuban vaccine has been validated by the WHO by Mr. Dr. Tedros. One of my people told me. So if the Cuban vaccine has been validated, because the Cubans are part of our group. They are part of Africans. So then we shall see which of these people want to redeem themselves, because this is a big shame on them. They need redemption. But this is the last, as far as Uganda is concerned, this is the last time we shall be in this type of situation. We shall develop our own capacity. And God is also on the side of the unlucky. We may also get other solutions, because we seem to be moving quite well on the therapeutic. So that's what I would like to say. Yes, in the short run, if they can, good, but they haven't.
The World Health Summit regional meeting features a special plenary of African ministers of health to review the state of COVID-19 in Africa and map a way forward, which will inform global health policy.